Liberty, and this is my GCU Life.
It is currently 5:20 a.m., and it is really early, so I'm gonna make my bed so I don't go back into bed. And you'll also notice that it is really dark outside still, so but it's time to get ready for the day. One thing about my morning routine that makes it 10 times easier is that than I have before, I'll lay out my clothes because it's really too early to think about what I want to wear right now, but I'm gonna get dressed. So now that we have some time to sit down and chat, I'm gonna introduce myself. My name is Liberty. I'm currently a junior studying medical engineering here at GCU. And I'm also from Phoenix, Arizona itself, so I'm local to the GCU area. After I'm done doing my hair and makeup, I then get to spend some time with Jesus in the morning. Today I'm going to be reading from Philippians 2, 3 through 4, so I'm going to do that and then write about how this verse stands out to me, how it relates to servanthood, and how ultimately I can apply it to my life, because I don't just want to talk about Jesus, I also want to walk with him. So I'll be taking some time to do that. This Bible, my notebook right here, and then the Bible study itself. So we are good to go for the day and get some coffee and then enter my first class at 7 a.m.
Now I'm off to my biosolid mechanics class for my 7 a.m. So hopefully I learn a lot about stress and tension and all that. But yeah, we're just having a great day.
My major is biomedical engineering. I'm currently a junior and I chose biomedical engineering because I love the aspect that I get to be hands-on, but also I get to interact with patients and ultimately give someone a better quality of life. What I hope to do is tissue engineering, so like making organs, like hearts, livers, lungs, things like that.
Now I'm off to my thermodynamics class at 8:30, and we're gonna be learning about refrigerators and how they work, heat pumps, heat engines, and all that fun stuff, so super excited.
So when I was in fourth grade, I went to a engineering camp and they kind of introduced me to the idea of biomedical engineering and kind of planted the seed in me. And then when I was a sophomore in high school, my dad was diagnosed with stage 4 skin cancer. And I saw the miracles that biomedical engineering did for them. He was on like immunotherapy, so a relatively new type of chemo treatment in a way. So looking at that and being like, oh, I really want to give back to this community who ultimately like saved my dad's life, and that whole situation ultimately like is the reason for my testimony as well. So it's been a long journey for him for sure, but it's awesome seeing him persevere through that, and it's just exciting to just gonna come from that.
Just eating some breakfast before I get studying pretty soon for some tests that I have this week, but for now, a little break from academics. So I have a quiz in biosolid mechanics and thermodynamics, and then in my circuits lecture as well tomorrow. So I have two quizzes tomorrow and then one on Friday, so trying to grind that out and study and get good grades on those.
So right now I am heading back to my dorm. Did like an hour and a half of studying, so I'm gonna take a little break before work and kind of get my life together and change into my polo and jeans.
I'm with my roommate, Aubrey. She was my roommate last year and now this year, so she's graduating this year, which makes me really sad. But I am all ready for work. Her fit's cute too. It is November here in Phoenix right now, so
it's a little chilly today.
Yeah, it's really cold. Right now I am on my way to work. I have my scooter. I'm about to give a tour of the engineering building, so I will see you guys at work.
So this is the engineering behind me. As a junior program development specialist for the College of Engineering, I get to walk families through this building that is a near 175,000 square feet, built at the tail end of 2016. So as a PDS, I get to just show families how cool engineering is, our fun workshops I'm gonna show you guys. So we're gonna head on in. This right here is our capstone room. Here as an engineering student, you actually start thinking about your capstone project your second semester of junior year. So for me, that's next semester, which is really exciting, but also super scary. What that looks like is I am given a $4,000 budget from the university with a team of other engineers like mechanical and electrical and all those other fun disciplines. But this right here, I love to talk about because this is a gurney that's electric on wheels. What these students did is originally they kind of made a contraption similar to this, but they had one tire in the back, and they actually got industry feedback on this design, and so they changed it, and so this really helps first responders in getting people out of the scary mountain.
So I just finished my tour, and now I'm heading back to my room to do some more work. So the nice thing about being a JPDS is that I get to often work from my dorm because a lot of it is just connecting and outreaching to students. So I'll be calling some students, and then I have an appointment scheduled with a student as well. So I get to share some of my experience here as an engineer and really see what they want to do with engineering as well if they decide to come here as a student. Just finished work. I got up at 4. It's now 4:03, and I am making some dinner, some leftovers. So I have rice from yesterday, and then I have peas and veggie rolls as well. I'd also like to note that my eating times are a little weird just because I wake up really early. I think the hardest thing about being a student sometimes is figuring out when to eat, because you're like, oh yeah, I can do this, and you're like, oh wait, I need to eat. So that's probably the hardest part about being an engineer, just figuring out when to eat.
Awesome, so we are at SWE. We're gonna be doing our welded rose project, and we have a bunch of girls here, so super exciting.
The GCU Society of Women Engineers are a section. They are a awesome group of either women in engineering or technology. A lot of it is just like empowering women engineers, but we really try to get women in the workshops.
So this will turn to this, and it's gonna look super cool. So get it on camera. So I'm gonna tack it 1, 2 right here.
Okay.
After that, I'm gonna let it cool.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna hammer it upwards.
Okay.
After I'm done with that, I'm gonna slide another one down from the bottom, and you keep building. That's it.
Wait, okay. One more time.
One thing I'm gonna tell you, do not be afraid to get close to this.
Okay.
Sometimes you'll see sparks coming from the top, but it's okay.
Okay.
So for welding, I'm just gonna make a big blob, essentially. You don't wanna hold it too long, but you want to make sure it's between this rod and this.
Okay, ready? Like that.
And then you just hammer it.
Oh, I didn't even.
Well, we are finished with our welding workshop. We only got part of the way finished, but next week we're gonna finish the rest of our roses.
So I just got back from my SWE meeting, and now I'm heading off to lip sync. I'll be supporting my friends in line dancing, Macy, on the quad today for lip sync.
We are on the way to lip sync to see Macy on the quad. Woo!
Just got back to my dorm from lip sync. I'm going to do some studying for a little bit. Right now it's like 10 o'clock because I have a little quiz tomorrow at 7 a.m. So I'm gonna get started on that and then hopefully be ready to go to bed by 10:30. This concludes my day as a woman engineer here at GCU. Thank you for coming along with me, and hope to see you guys on more adventures. Good night.